Dear children, today's class you are going to study the concept of rational numbers. Before knowing about rational number, let us see different types of numbers in the number system. Here I have mentioned five different types of numbers of number system. They are natural number, whole number, integers, rational number and irrational number. Natural numbers are represented by the symbol n. Whole numbers are represented by the symbol W, integers are represented by symbol Z, rational number by Q and irrational number by P. Let us see in detail about each and every different types of numbers here. Natural numbers are the numbers that begins from 1 and it continues. All the numbers 1, 2, 3 and continuous number from that up to infinity are said to be natural numbers. Whole numbers are the numbers including 0 and the natural number. Integers are the numbers including negative number, 0 and positive numbers. Rational numbers are the numbers which are written in the form of P by Q and Q not equal to 0. Irrational numbers are the number which cannot be written in the form of P by Q. Make a note. See all the different types of number, which alphabet is used to represent the number and what is the meaning of those numbers. Natural numbers include all the counting numbers. Whole numbers are the numbers which include 0 and natural number. Integers are including negative number, 0 and positive numbers. Rational number you are going to study in detail in this lesson about rational number, where the numbers are written in terms of P by Q and Q is not equal to 0. And irrational number which cannot be written in the form of P by Q. Next let us see the meaning of rational number. So rational numbers, as I already told you, rational numbers are the numbers which are written in the form of P by Q. So here P by Q means P and Q are integers here. So you can put any number in the place of P by Q. If I write 1 by 2, now you can get the confusion between rational number and fraction numbers. Because rational numbers are written in terms of P by Q. It is nothing but 1 by 2 is the example I have given. Same thing is also called as a fraction number. So now let us see what is the difference between the fraction number and the rational numbers. So in fraction number, you can make a note that only positive numbers or whole numbers are included. In fractions, only whole numbers are included. But in the rational number, integers are used. As you know, integers are including negative number, 0 and positive numbers. That is the difference between this rational number and the fractions. So, the definition of the rational number, the numbers in the form of P by Q is called as a rational number, where P and Q are integers. Integers, it can include negative number, 0 and positive number, but Q should not be 0. Why? You see, if you are writing P by Q is a rational number and if I take P as 1 and instead of Q if I take as 0, then 1 by 0 it is nothing but infinity which is not defined. So you are writing here in the definition Q is not equal to 0. And the rational numbers, it is derived from the Italian word which means quotient. Rational numbers are derived from the Italian word which means quotient. Okay. Now let us see different types of rational numbers. So in rational numbers there are two types. One is positive rational number and second one is negative rational number. If the rational numbers are having the like sign, example if the numerator and denominator both are positive, or if both the numerator and denominator are negative, that means both are, if they are having the like sign, then we call it as a positive rational numbers. And either of the numerator or denominator they are having the different sign, then it is said to be negative rational numbers. So here If numerator and denominator both are having the positive sign like 2 by 3 or minus 5 by minus 6, here you can make a note that both numerator and denominator are having plus symbol and here both are having minus symbol. If the symbols are same, if the like symbols are there in the numerator and denominator, we call it as a positive rational number. Similarly, if you are having the example like minus 2 by 6 and 5 by minus 3. Here you can see they are not having numerator and denominator having different sign. In the first example, you can see it is minus 2 and plus 6. So unlike symbols are there. In the second example, you are having plus 5 and minus 3. So different symbols are there in the numerator and denominator. Such type of numbers are said to be negative rational numbers. Now we can see the standard form of the rational number. The standard form of the rational number should have the numerator and denominator having the factor 1. See example, here it is mentioned 4 by 7. In 4 by 7, the number 4 and 7 both are having the common factor as 1. That means both the number is divisible only by the number 1. For example, if I take the number 2 divided by 6, if I consider the rational number 2 divided by 6, then it is not the standard form of rational number because 2 and 6, it goes in the table 1 and 2. To say that it is a standard form, it should be divisible only by the number 1. You have to take, it should be divisible only by the number 1. But here you are having 1 and 2. So it is not considered to be the standard form of rational number. To say that any number is in the standard form, its numerator and denominator, it should have the common factor only 1. So now let us see different properties of rational number. You are having together 6 properties of rational number. They are closure property, associative property, commutative property, distributive property, identity property, and inverse property. In the coming class, next class, you are going to study in detail about all the properties of these rational numbers. So, students, hope you are all cleared with the introduction to this rational number chapter. So, here I have mentioned the 2 links. If you have any doubt or if you want to know more about the rational number, click on these links and get more information about the rational numbers. So in the next class, we are going to study about the properties of rational numbers. Be prepared. Thank you.